I want to call up the team from Rebelle Rally, Lily, Alex, Kelly, and Nicole. So Lilly Macaruso attended her first Rebelle Rally in 2016 and was actually the one to first introduce Rivian to the Rebelle Rally when she joined as a special project engineer in 2020. Alex Anderson is a senior mechanical engineer for Rivian. She helps create products and accessories for our vehicles. And she got married 2 weeks after last year's Rebelle Rally and drove away from the wedding in their rally vehicle. Kelly Kennedy was a Rebelle Rally rookie this year and works as an employee communications manager at Rivian. She says her time at Rivian and being a Rebelle has been her greatest adventure yet. Nicole Johnson is a director of human-machine interface at Rivian, overseeing the design and user experience of the screens in Rivian vehicles. Okay, so, Alex, how did it feel to win?
It was an incredible experience. I'll be honest, we came into the rally not with expectations that we would win. We were rookies of the year last year, and before that, we had absolutely no experience navigating off-road for 1,600 miles, finding these checkpoints in the middle of the desert that there may or may not be a flag there. This was a completely new experience to us. There was a lot of really seasoned rebels who had competed for 5 years in a row and had won 3 years in a row. So those expectations were not there for us. And we actually didn't know the majority of the rally what our rank was. We didn't need to. It would have messed with our head if we did know. So we actually discovered it the last day of the rally when we crossed the finish line and a bunch of people were like looking at our car. And they're like, they're kind of whispering, and we're like, did we just win? Did that actually just happen? And it was confirmed later in the day, and again, it just absolutely incredible experience.
That's amazing. I remember I was in the car, and I got a text that we might have just won the Rebelle Rally, and I was like so excited.
I like how you said that, we. You got a text that we, because it wasn't. because we didn't do it alone, and I just wanted to acknowledge that moment, because you were a part of it.
Yeah.
Everyone here was a part of it, because otherwise that vehicle wouldn't be that spectacular. It would be a car that completed the rally, but wouldn't have been something we did.
Yeah. So. And Lily, you've been a part of the Rebelle Rally. You attended it in 2016, right? Did you ever imagine that you were going to win the competition?
2016, I was still in college. And I walked out of one of my finals because one of the founders of the rally said, we don't take kids here. We also don't take interns. But if you don't, that's not a word we can say here. But if you don't mess it up, sure, you can come. And to go from that moment into the winner's circle with Alex and a phenomenal team, magical, inspiring, unbelievable, impossible.
All right, Nicole, why do you think representation is important in spaces like off-roading and motorsports and just the tech industry in general? And how have you seen it change since you started school and throughout your career?
Yeah, that's a great question. So representation for me is interesting because I think there's an aspect of delusion when I realize and think back to my past of I kind of moved through spaces not really thinking that I didn't belong there or that there would be the idea that I didn't belong there. So I think when I think about how people identify with themselves and with the world around them, it's mostly has to do with how normal it feels. So if it feels normal, then you feel that you belong there and it doesn't really matter. Just a funny story. When we were out at one of our trainings, we were at a Target or Walmart or something like that, and I was looking for camping supplies, and because we had forgotten something. And this older African-American woman was working there, and I said, oh, excuse me, ma'am, do you know where to find, you know, blah, 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 and camping section. And she goes, huh, you're going camping? And I go, yeah. And she goes, huh, you be safe out there. And it just, it didn't occur to her that that was something that, you know, someone that looks like me might do. But for me, it never occurred to me that it's something I wouldn't do. And I think the important aspect of that and the takeaway is something actually that, you know, we actually do naturally, I think, at Rivian is the amalgam of minds and different types of people and ideas that make our product so amazing is actually just something that's so deeply ingrained. And I think that's what enables different folks from all different walks of life to really thrive in an environment, or for me to end up doing a rally. If you would have asked me, you know, 10 years ago, a kid from the Midwest, am I going to be off-roading in the sand dunes that looks like you're on Mars? No. But in the end, again, being able to make sure that the people around you feel that they belong, I think is really the most important aspect of that. And that's something that, as you know, the next 10 to 20 years, I think we can dissolve the need to even use the word representation, because it just becomes normal.
I hope so. So this is a two-part question for Nicole and Alex again. So the Rivian that we see over there and all the Rivians that you competed with in the rally are the same stock vehicles that every Rivian owner has in their driveway, except there are a few modifications. So Nicole, can you tell us about the modifications to the software? What's the special rally software package?
The special rally package is, and I think probably worth noting that the reason the modifications exist is kind of twofold. The first one is there are certain things software-wise that we literally can't have as a part of a rally build. For example, in our new drive modes that I think some of you saw on the screen back there, there's a compass. Can't have a compass on the screen for a rally where you're not supposed to know where you are. And that's part of the actual manual aspect of it. So there's certain things we need to take away. And then there are safety things, like we need to turn certain things off for the rally in order to make sure we're qualified to compete. And so the other part of it is sometimes we have interesting ideas that we want to try in terms of there's so much data that exists in our vehicle because it's software defined that we can pull that out and leverage that as a tool for figuring out how warm the motors are or what the battery temp is. And so there's certain aspects of that that is required, and there's certain things that we end up trying out, and it becomes a, I don't want to call it a playground, but an opportunity to test the new things out as we grow and expand features and product.
That's awesome. Okay. And Alex, can you tell us about like the physical modifications, like the changes that you made to the storage and the seating that helped you in the rally? I know a bunch of people got to like look around and play with it today. So.
Yeah, if you guys haven't checked it out, feel free to climb in the vehicle and check it out. So like Grace said, those vehicles are stock. They perform exactly the same as the R1T or R1S that you have in your driveway. But this is a highly technical competition. We have a lot of tools, both to change tires, to work on the vehicle.
There were 2 years and we went through two tires, to be clear.
She did good. So we have a lot of tools. And then as a navigator, I almost have to build my office because I am dealing with rulers, plotters, everything on the go while the car is getting jumbled up. So everything is
smoothly jumbled up.
So everything has to be Velcroed or else I'll lose it, because I'm also not a very coordinated person. So with the support of our special projects team, and I sat down for a few hours and designed these parts up, I made some center console inserts that hold our coffee cups, pencils, compass, lower console insert that's for your larger water bottles. And then most importantly for me, there was a dash insert that made the dash flat, and it allowed me to Velcro all my tools to it.
One other thing I'll highlight is that in 2022, we had an S compete, which is what myself and Rosanna Nutch, who was my navigator, drove. And Alex actually helped create this really awesome. We took out the rear seats and actually essentially created a second gear tunnel, or a gear tunnel in the S that doesn't exist, which was really awesome, made out of wood. So that was all Alex as well. So, you know, the tease was awesome, but that for me was just amazing because we had storage compartments that didn't exist before. And I wish it was something, you know, we could make in the future.
I mean, I wish we had it here today. That would have been cool to show up.
It is the most cuddly rally car I've ever seen. Oh, but that conversation actually started because of the fact that Alex goes, what do we want to organize? And I essentially was like, you. How do we help you? So it was just, what do you want? How do you build it? And that's the theme I hope everyone has seen here tonight, and every single piece of this is the fact of, what do you want to do? How are we going to do it? We'll figure that out. It'll be fine.
And that's why we were so lucky as rookies. So I was one of our rookie teams this year. I drove 196 Evergreen Edge. And all through our training, like, Lily and Alex and Nicole were just running us through the ringer, really like making sure that we knew we could handle it. And then we finally get to the packing stage and there's just a mountain of stuff. I'm like, I literally don't know where this goes. And Alex is just like, it goes. It goes in the truck.
Everything has its place, and everything goes in its place.
Goes in the place. That truck was Velcro and metal, mostly, for us, with all of our pencils and plotters and compasses. That's and my awesome. Snacks.
So Kelly and Rachel were attempting to be so efficient that they were attempting to eliminate things like blankets, like extra coats. Ooh. And I looked at them, and I'm like, I think I called you, and I was like, please take your coat.
Okay, Nicole, this is so unfair because I have read the question. So Ray is, you know, we're going to talk a little bit about mentorship and me as the rookie. And this is kind of my story. So thank you, Nicole. Thinking about the mentorship aspect, like having never been through this before and having a really amazing group of women being around me to look me in the eye and say, you're going to do that hard thing. And you are hopefully going to do it better than they did last year, which we all knew it was not going to be true because Lily and Alex were going to bring home the gold. But yes, Nicole begged me to take an extra jacket. And I said, I'm going to be fine. We're going to be totally fine. And I was thanking her when it was 14 degrees for the first three nights. And I, you know, we get into the truck and I'm like, I don't even know if my fingers are going to wrap around the steering wheel at this point. It's that cold. So thank you for the extra jacket and the mentorship.
Do you feel appreciated, Nicole?
I do. I really do.
Okay. And another question for Kelly. Why do you think it was important for Rivian to build its own, like, homegrown in the Rivian backyard team? And what benefits does that bring to you all, to the Rebelle team, and also to the company as a whole?
I mean, you know, I can't think of anything else that would be more Rivian for us to do, because it's really about how we build a connection between people and our vehicles. And I would say, you know, all the owners out here, you have a really special connection with your vehicles. It's such a special thing to work at the company that makes them and then be able to drive the thing and take it somewhere and say, I was a part of that. And so that's the most Rivian thing that I can think of for us to do. So it kind of felt like the natural answer. But I work in communications, and it's almost been my second year anniversary at Rivian just last week.
God,
last year. 1 week is 1 year in Rivian time. And I remember working on the communications for Rebelle 2022 and watching Alex and Lily and learning about the format and hearing Nicole talk about calculations and math. And I thought, I don't know if I can ever do that. And here I am a year later having done it and having looked, you know, in the eye of all these mentors and had them say, you're going to do it just like I did. And we just look forward to what that means for our off-roading community, for the Rebelle community, but also for Rivian to be able to inspire. You know, I had never driven an EV before earlier this year. And to say that I did not change a tire this year at the rally is something really special.
Love that.
If I can just add one thing, I also just want to say that speaks volumes of Rivian that they were willing to take the risk on all of us sitting here today. We came in with no experience to this. Some of us had not had our tires hit dirt. So the fact that they were willing to invest the time, resources, and literal vehicles that we could have destroyed but we didn't. And we were showing on a very public stage that speaks volumes. And the fact that this is a women's rally on top of that, just really thank you.
So you're all wonderful, you're all great, interesting, blah, blah, blah. But there is somebody else in the theater tonight that has a lot of experience with off-roading and Rebelle Rally. So Mandy, Verzina, are you out there? Can I ask you a question, please? So Mandy, as an avid off-roader and actually an off-road driving instructor, you've worked with a lot of capable off-road vehicles, right? So why did you choose an R1T to be your third teammate in the Rebelle Rally?
It's an amazing vehicle, short answer. I actually had the vehicle before last year's rally, but knew that it was gonna be very difficult to get it there. I thought it was a badge of honor to be able to bring your own vehicle there. So my first rally was actually 2020. I got to see Rivian's first rally, so I feel like I kind of grew with Rivian in the rally. So it was very cool to see how far it progressed. And then when I had my own, I really wanted to take it. I have always had a gas vehicle prior to in the last three rallies, so being able to take an EV this year was completely different. It was a whole new challenge, but it was a really cool challenge to be out in these beautiful places with so many amazing people and just to be able to enjoy the environment. It was so quiet. It was so cool. The sand is my favorite. So very proud of you ladies. It's been fun watching you over the years. So it was a pleasure to be part of Team Rivian this year. Thank you all very much.
Thank you, Mandy. Thank you all so much. Amazing answers. It was lovely to talk to you. And thank you to Jennifer and everyone at Team Rivian who helped organize this show and this interview.